How do I look?
Fred, would you like to take this one?
Well, it's not an outfit I would have put together, but it looks very smart on you, son.
You're not going outside with that wet hair, are you, dear?
Mom, my hair isn't wet. I put Vitalis in it. Look, it's in a cool ducktail, just like Dad's.
Chris, you're not becoming one of those mafia wise guy good fellas, are you?
Dad, come on. That kind of break takes the sort of connections I just don't have. No, I'm all dressed up like this because my boss wants to see me. And I think it's because I'm getting a promotion.
A promotion? Oh, Chris, that's wonderful. Do you think it'll be a desk job?
Mom, please, no. I'm as much a part of the streets as the gum on the sidewalk is, as the cigarette butts in the cracks, as the worms that come out after a summer's rain to make sweet love under the hot afternoon sun. I'm sorry, I'm getting way too poetic. No, I'll never give up the streets.
Well, it's nice to see such dedication. It's asinine and it's misguided, but it's dedication.
They probably want to expand my territory to reward a job well done. But you know what? It's going to cost them. Here's my list of demands. Apply cream to affected area twice daily. Oh, I'm sorry, that's my ointment instructions. Don't ask, Dad.
Don't worry, I won't.
Maybe you should just accept what they offer you, dear.
Ma, that's the kind of rollover attitude that has us still driving a Monte Carlo instead of a hovercraft.
Chris, you can't drive a hovercraft on the highway.
Dad, I don't want to get into this argument with you again, okay? The point is, I have the newspaper right where I want them. Here's my real list of demands. I need a padded seat for my bike, a thermos, and a mistress on 24-hour call, 7 days a week.
Good luck, dear.
Gladys, if they give him a mistress, I'm getting a paper route.
Great.
Thanks, Ronnie.
Peterson, how long have you been a paperboy?
Well, let's see now. There's, 1, 2, 3, 18 years in January.
Well, for many of those 18 years, you've been a valued employee.
Well, thanks, Ronnie. I think I know what you're trying to say.
And as you know, here at the paper, we're always looking for ways to improve performance.
Well, yeah, me too. Like when I was taking steroids, remember? It's terrible what happens when you stop, though. The muscle just turns right to fat.
Now, this chart represents the productivity we can expect from the average 12-year-old paperboy. Of course, your results are somewhat better since you've mastered the job over the last 2 decades. Are you with me so far?
Well, actually, to be honest, I'm a little more comfortable with pie graphs. Please continue.
Well, as you can see, we've had generally good performance with just a few dips representing sick days and vacations. But on the whole, we've been quite pleased with the results.
I think I know what's coming.
That's why we're sorry to lose you.
I don't know what you're talking about.
There's a new paperboy in town. Let me introduce Paperboy 2000. The high-tech answer to newspaper delivery. This machine does the work of all our paperboys faster and in a much more economical fashion. In fact, we estimate savings of up to $4 a week.
$4 a week?
I know it doesn't sound like much, but over the course of a year, it really adds up.
Well, I guess if you put it that way, it does kind of sound impressive. Wow, what a day. You got this fancy new machine and I'm getting a raise. Let's go out and have a party.
Peterson, you're not comprehending this, are you? You're fired.
What? Well, this is just a blatant case of sexual discrimination, cut and dry and wrapped up with a little bow.
No, it's because of Paperboy 2000. Time marches on, Peterson. Soon Paperboy 2000 will be a staple of American life. Mark my words, Peterson. If Norman Rockwell were alive today, he'd be painting this baby.
Norman Rockwell's dead? Gosh. You know, I just need about 5 hours of quiet time alone in this office, please.
Don't worry, Peterson. I'm sure you'll land on your feet. Well, to be honest, I have my doubts about that. Anyway, pass the news on to the other paper boys. Tomorrow is your last day.
Do you think it would be possible on my last day for you to provide me with a mistress? Dr. Kramer, thanks for coming. Mrs. Whitman?
We're here to support you, Chris.
You know, Chris, losing a job is one of the leading causes of stress-related illness. So whatever you do, try not to die.
I'll try, Doc.
This is a terrible thing. Being replaced by a machine. It's like 1984.
The year's 1990, Doc, but, I appreciate the sentiment.
All right, let's get started. Let's settle down. Let's settle down, people. I know we're all so anxious to hear from our own Chris Peterson. He called this meeting to discuss his paper route. But first, is there any other business? Sharon Potter, very well.
Thank you, Mrs. Trogdon. Residents of Greenville, we are all in grave danger. The results of the tests are in, and it has been confirmed. There are dangerously high levels of radon in Greenville's basement. Now, we must do something about this problem.
Okay, Sharon. Whoa, boy, war of the worlds. Oh, they're all coming down with ray guns. Oh, I'm so scared. Okay, I think Officer Burrell has some documents for you to sign. There she goes. Sharon Potter, ladies and gentlemen. Wasn't she wonderful? Oh, my. Always with the Hollywood causes. She insulted me and she insulted all of you. But now she's gone, it's like somebody opened a window in here, huh? Now on to things we all really care about. As most of you have already probably heard, all the paper boys were fired today. Oh. That's right, but the worst thing about all of this is that we're being replaced by a machine.
No.
Now, I know that as a paper boy, I have a few faults.
No, Chris, you're a great paper boy.
Larry, I know. It just added a nice rhythm to my speech.
No machine could replace you.
This is an outrage.
Wait! Before you make a decision, I think you should hear more about our high-tech friend. Picture having your paper delivered by a state-of-the-art, sleek, shiny, whisper-quiet robotic buddy. With its own guidance system.
Wow! Our very own robot?
Are you saying it's just like living in outer space?
Yes, very much like living in space.
You mean like the Jetsons?
Yes, the Jetsons!
When can we see it?
It's idling right outside!
Wait! Wait! No, don't go! It's a trick! He's the devil! Don't go!
Larry, you're my best friend. How can you do this to me?
I don't know. It just sounds kind of neat.
Oh, my God, that's amazing. Really great.
What a great idea.
Don't go, folks. It's just a fad. Remember what happened with the metric system? Everybody had such high hopes, and then nothing.
He's been so depressed since he lost his job to Paperboy 2000.
Well, on the bright side, we have been getting the paper earlier and in better condition. Plus, it's a lot like living in space.
Hi, Dad. Hi, Mom.
My, you're in an awfully good mood this morning.
That's right. You know, last night I realized I had to think things out. So I gave myself a full-body herbal rub down. And I realized that I really should have given up my paper route a long time ago.
Yeah, like maybe when you were 12 years old?
You know, I know now that somewhere out there, there's got to be a better job for me. I mean, I could be anything. I could be a jet pilot, or maybe a policeman, or the president of the United States, or maybe a cowboy. The point is, I'm not going to let this get me down. I'm going to go out there, I'm going to pound the pavement until I find a better job. And I'm not going to let anything between the moon and New York City stop me.
Oh, this door's locked. Oh, who am I kidding? I failed. I'm a loser.
Well, he gave it his best shot, Gladys.
Oh. Come in.
Are you okay? Your father and I are worried about you, right, Fred?
Oh, my God, look at this garbage scowl. I didn't realize how bad off you really were, Chris. You completely bottomed out.
No, Fred, his room's always been this vile and disgusting. He's just kind of a pig.
Well, that's a relief.
No, Dad, you're right. I have just kind of let myself go. Look at me. I look like Foster Brooks. Remember, he's the gentleman from those roasts, and he'd come out and he'd hiccup. And
we know who he is, Chris.
Oh, he'd make us laugh and forget our problems for a while. I could sure go for a visit from good old Foster Brooks right about now.
Gladys, you think too much TV as a kid can make you an idiot?
Oh, I miss my old job. I miss sitting snugly on my bicycle seat, going over particularly bumpy parts of the road, and thinking about girls.
Fred, say something to him. Give him one of your pep talks.
Chris, knock it off. You're driving us nuts. Okay, I think we got through to him. Let's get the hell out of here.
Fred, look, it's Paperboy 2000. I never thought we'd live to see something like this in our lifetime.
Oh, nice job, Gladys. My little speech was just beginning to sink in.
Honey, I'm sorry. I kind of miss you delivering our newspapers to us, but it's not your fault. No one can beat a machine.
Beat a machine. Beat a machine.
Wait a second, Ma. That's exactly what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna... Wait, what am I gonna do?
Beat a machine?
Yeah, that. Thanks. Thanks.
He's going to make a horse's ass out of himself.
Thank you.
They want high tech. I'll give them high tech.
Hey, look, everybody. Hey, it's just like living in space.
It's nothing like living in space, you moron.
Chris, remember, no matter what happens today, they can't take away your dignity. Because you pretty much did that yourself with that outfit.
Larry, if I don't make it, I want you to know that my will is underneath my mattress in my bedroom. I'm leaving everything to my parents, except for my dirty laundry. I'm leaving that to Sharon. The specific order is that she separate the colors when she washes them. Because even though I'll be dead, I'll still want my colors separated. She's got to do it, right? I mean, if it's my last wish.
It's the law.
She's going to be so PO'd.
Look, everybody! Here comes Paperboy 2000!
Excuse me, could somebody tell me which end of this tin can is the butt? Because I'm just about to kick it.
You know, Peterson, you're a gutsy, emotionally troubled kid. And, well, between us, I hope you win. Who am I kidding? I don't want you to win. I look like a total idiot.
All right, everybody, ready?
Quick, let's slink away before someone notices the family resemblance.
Chris, are you okay?
I'm okay.
Well, actually, you did better than I thought you would. I figured you'd just fall over and set your clothes on fire.
Well, Larry, I'm not an idiot.
I guess it's over, Chris.
Yeah, I guess so. I guess Socrates was right. You just can't beat a big, high-tech, computer-driven newspaper delivery system. But you know what? I'm man enough to take my failure in stride. You son of a bitch!
I hate you!
Imagine if there'd been a baby in there.
Chris, that was brilliant. What did you do to finally get it to stop?
I don't know. I think it just kind of ran out of gas.
Chris, you're a hero. If it wasn't for you, this baby carriage could have needed major repairs.
Well, Peterson, I guess you made your point. Paperboy 2000 is flawless, except if someone kicks it in the tire, it turns into an out-of-control killing machine. It's starting to make sense why they banned this thing in Eastern Europe. I'm beginning to think that the risk to innocent people outweighs the extra $4 a week for human paperboys. You know something? Pending approval from the head office, we're rehiring all the old paperboys.
Oh, wait a second. Maybe I don't want your little job back, huh? Did you ever think about that? Maybe I want to be the tinfoil woodsman in the town, adored by all the children from now on.
Well, you've got a better offer?
No, I said maybe. Come on, what are you talking about? Of course I want my job back. Hey, everybody, I'm back. Yeah! And you know something? I think we've all kind of learned a valuable lesson here today. That a man, no matter how puny or bald or overweight or bearded, can still have a place in today's society that's mostly ruled by corporate biddity-bobbity-boobity-boos, and that one man's voice can still be heard over the endless drone of those that seem to drone on endlessly. And actually, what we shouldn't do is chit-chat, really, for tomorrow is Labor Day. Hey, where's everyone going?
Mandel singing to the Cub Scouts of America? Don't ask, just watch. It's an all-new Good Grief later tonight. This Friday, John Walsh hits the streets of New York to show you how violent crime is crippling the city and how ordinary citizens are fighting back on America's Most Wanted. Stay tuned now for Married with Children next.